Hello, my dear class 9 children. Once again, I am with you to do the questions of chapter 19b based on trigonometry from this book. Let's do the remaining questions of the exercise. I start with question number 14. The question is, tan theta 5 by 12. We have to find cos theta minus sin theta upon cos theta plus sin theta. We have two options, two methods to get the answer. First method, getting the values, after getting the values of cos theta and sin theta, using the triangle and putting the value here. Second one, we can use the quotient relation. What is the quotient relation? We know that sin theta upon cos theta is tan theta. I repeat, sin theta upon cos theta is equal to tan theta. So if both numerator and denominator we divide by cos theta, the numerator will convert to 1 minus tan theta and denominator will convert to 1 plus tan theta. Let us do it by using quotient relation. What am I saying? I am saying divide both numerator and denominator by the same ratio cos theta. So you will get here cos theta upon cos theta minus sin theta upon cos theta. Cos theta upon cos theta plus sin theta upon cos theta 1. Therefore, this changes to 1 minus tan theta upon 1 plus tan theta. Since tan theta is 5 by 12, so when we put 5 by 12 here in the numerator and denominator both, and simplify the numerator and denominator, we get twelve plus five upon twelve. I hope you know this shortcut method. You can cancel out 12. So you will get 7/17 as the answer. So I have got the answer using the quotient relation. My dear students, you can get the answer using the triangles method. What in that triangle method. Using the relation P by H, B by H and P by B. I mean, when you do it by second method, you can write it as the ratio of perpendicular to base. So perpendicular is 5 unit, base is 12 unit, therefore the hypotenuse H using the Pythagoras theorem can be written as the sum of the square of perpendicular and base. Sum of the squares of perpendicular and base, which finally becomes 169, and after taking the square root it comes as 13. Therefore, to get the value of cos theta minus sin theta upon cos theta plus sin theta, we will express these ratios in the terms of perpendicular, base and hypotenuse. So cos theta is the ratio of base to hypotenuse. Base is 12 and hypotenuse is 13. So 12 upon 13. Sin theta is the ratio of perpendicular to hypotenuse. Perpendicular is 5. And hypotenuse is 13. Similarly, this cos theta, which is already written here, 12 by 13, sin theta, 5 by 13. So when we simplify this complex fraction, we get the numerator as 7 by 13 and denominator as 17 by 13. Cancel it. So finally the answer is same what we have got here in this case. So you are free to use any of these two methods. Next one. Question number 15. In this question, we have 5 sin theta equals to 4. With the help of this, we have to find the value of 1 plus sin theta upon 1 minus sin theta. Very simple question. To get the value of this fraction, this expression, we will first get the value of sin theta from this equation. Since 5 sin theta equals to 4, therefore, sin theta equals to 4 by 5. Hence, 1 plus sin theta upon 1 minus sin theta becomes 1 plus 4 by 5 upon 1 minus 4 by 5. LCM is 5. So, 5 plus 4 by 5. 5 minus 4 by 5. So we get the answer as 9 upon 1, 9. Next one. B tan theta equals to A. So if B tan theta equals to A, therefore tan theta, no doubt it will be A by B. Okay? Now what we want? To find cos theta plus sin theta upon cos theta minus sin theta. So with the value of tan theta, when we want to get the value of this fraction, we can use two method. To get the value of this fraction with the value with the help of tan theta, we have two options. In question number 14, I used that. Either we can use the quotient relation, I mean this can be changed to 1 plus tan theta and 1 minus tan theta, or use the triangles property, P perpendicular base and hypotenuse. So I prefer to do this by quotient relation. So to do this by quotient relation, we need to divide both numerator and denominator by the cos theta. And when we divide each term of the numerator by cos theta, it becomes 1 plus tan theta. Similarly, when denominator is divided by cos theta, the terms become 1 minus tan theta. Put the value of tan theta here, from there to here, 1 plus a by b and 1 minus a by b. When we take LCM, this becomes b plus a and this becomes b minus a by b. Cancel. So the final answer is b plus a upon b minus a. Question number 17. We have 5 tan theta equals to 4. So my dear students, if 5 tan theta is 4, therefore tan theta will be 4 upon 5. What we want now? We want to find 5 sin theta minus 3 cos theta upon 5 sin theta plus 2 cos theta. So the fraction which we want to simplify involves two ratios only, sine and cos. And the value what we have is the value of tan theta. So we can change these to tan theta using the quotient relation. What does quotient relation say? Quotient relation says that when sin theta is divided by cos theta, the quotient comes tan theta. So when we divide the denominator and numerator both by cos theta, the terms changes to 5 tan theta minus 3 phi tan theta plus 2. It is better to use 5 tan theta as 4. So this 5 tan theta can be replaced by 4. So 4 minus 3 upon 4 plus 2. We get the answer as 1 upon 6. Question number 18. Thirteen sine A equals to 5. Therefore, sine A equals to 5 upon 13. We want to get the value of 5 sin A minus 2 cos A upon tan A. So perpendicular and hypotenuse we have. Let us get the value of base. To get the value of base using the perpendicular and hypotenuse, we need to use Pythagoras theorem, which says that base is equal to under root hypotenuse square minus perpendicular square. 169 minus 25, 144, which is 12. So 12 units. So therefore, when we put here sine A, which is the ratio of perpendicular and hypotenuse, so perpendicular's value is 5, hypotenuse is 30. Cos A, base upon hypotenuse, base we have calculated here 12, hypotenuse 30. Tan A is the ratio of perpendicular to base. Perpendicular is 5. Base is 12. It's the time to simplify it. 5 into 5. 25 by 30. Minus 24 by 30. Upon 5 by 12. The denominators are same. So to do the subtraction, we will subtract 24 from 25. 1 upon 30 divided by 5 by 12. When we simplify this, we write it as 1 upon 30 multiplied by 12 by 5, which becomes 12 upon 65. Last question. The last question is question number 19. Since 5 cos A minus 12 sin A equals to 0. So we can change this relation to a single ratio relation. This equation or relation involves two ratios. We can convert this equation to an equation with one ratio only. How? Let us learn. 5 cos A equals to 12 sin A. Okay? When you shift this subtraction to that side, it becomes addition 0 plus 12 sin A. Now, using the quotient relation which says that cos A upon sin A is cot A or sin A upon cos A is tan A, we can change this to a single ratio of which is equal to tan A. So I am doing, I divide both sides by cos A. Cancel. It becomes 5. And here we get 12 tan A. Therefore, my dear students, when I ask you tan A is equal to, so some of you say makes mistake, some of you make mistake here. When I say 5 equals to 12 tan A, then tan A equals to, some of you say 12 by 5, which is wrong. You want tan A, so this 12, which is multiplier here, will become divisor for this side. So 5 upon 12. So the value of tan A is 5 upon 12, which is the ratio of perpendicular to base. Okay? Now what we want? We want to get a fraction with sine and cos, two ratios only, sine A plus cos A upon 2 cos A minus sine A. So the value of tan A we have, we want to get this. Two options. Either use the triangles property, perpendicular base, you have get the value of hypotenuse and put here. Or change these ratios to tan A using quotient relation, divide by cos A. So this becomes sin A upon cos A, tan A. Cos A upon cos A, 1. 2, cos A upon cos A, it is 1. Sin A upon cos A, tan A. After putting the value of tan A, which is 5 by 12, when we simplify, to simplify this, we need to take LCM. We get 5 plus 12. We get 24 minus 5 by 12. Cancel. 17 upon 19. So this is the final answer. So we have finished this exercise. Let's go to the next exercise. In this exercise, we will be using the values of standard angles. So, let me explain you which angles are considered as the standard angles of a right angle of a triangle. In the trigonometry, when we consider one angle of a triangle as 90, the triangle is called right angle triangle, and hence these two angles will become the acute angles and they are complement to each other, means their sum will be 90. So if this is theta, this will become 90 minus theta. So in trigonometry, my dear students, 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. These angles are considered as standard angles. These angles are considered as standard angles. So we are going to make a table which involves the three basic trigonometrical ratios, sine theta, cos theta and tan theta. The value of sine 0 degree is 0. The value of sine 30 degree is 1 by 2. The value of sine 45 degree is 1 by root 2. The value of sine 60 degree is root 3 by 2. The value of sine 90 degree is 1. The value of cos theta, cos 0 degree is 1. What you have to do? If you write all the 5 values of sine, to write the 5 values of cos, you have to change the order. I mean, 1 is the last value, it becomes first value. Then second last becomes second value. So cos 30 degree is root 3 by 2, cos 45 degree is 1 by root 2, cos 30 means sine 60, cos 60 is half, cos 90 becomes 0, tan theta, the division of 0 by 1, because tan theta is a ratio which is equal to sine theta upon cos theta. So 0 divided by 1 will give you the value of tan theta, 0. 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2, 2 to cancel. So tan 30 degree is 1 by root 3, tan 45 degree when you do division you will get 1. Tan 60, do the division, root 3. 1 by 0, this is a new term, when 1 is divided by 0, we get a non-real value which is considered as infinite. It is not imaginary, it is a number which is called infinite. Okay? Now, the three more ratios are there, which are the reciprocal of these three. So, if somebody asks the value of cosec 0, so get the reciprocal of 0 by 1. One new thing I would like to tell you, memorize it. 1 by 0 is infinite, while 0 by 1 is 0. So the other values, cos, cot and sec, which are reciprocal of these three, I am not writing, we can get from this table. And remember, this table which I have written here is not the trigonometrical ratio table. Some of you get confused. Sir, in the question it is written that without using the trigonometrical ratio table, find the value. I would like to show you. This table is called trigonometrical ratio table. You can see natural sines. You can see natural cosines. नेचुरल साइंस, नेचुरल कोसाइंस, नेचुरल टेंजेंट्स. सो दीज वैल्यूज आर कॉल्ड द वैल्यूज फ्रॉम ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिकल रेशियो टेबल. सो वेन इट इज रिटन इन द क्वेश्चन विदाउट यूजिंग द ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिकल रेशियो टेबल मीन्स सच अ टेबल विच यू विल गेट ओनली इन द बुक. सो दैट टेबल यू नीड नॉट टू यूज, बट दिस वन यू कैन यूज. सो यू नीड टू मेमोराइज ऑल दीज वैल्यूज, एंड वेन यू मेमोराइज यू कैन यूज इट टू इवैल्युएट द क्वेश्चन ऑफ द नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज. एक्सरसाइज सी, बिफोर डूइंग द क्वेश्चन ऑफ एक्सरसाइज सी माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्लेन यू वन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. I draw a right angle triangle and mention its vertices as A, B and C with capital letters A, B and C. So you know that this side is hypotenuse. These two are considered as perpendicular and base depending on the angles. If you consider this angle for the reference, so this side becomes perpendicular and then this base. So if this vertex is shown by capital letter B, then the side opposite to this vertex B is shown by a small letter B. So this B, small b, this is small b, shows the length of AC. This vertex is A, so side opposite to this vertex A, which is BC, is shown by a small letter A. Side opposite to vertex C is shown by a small letter C. So I hope it is clear to you. A small b is the length of AC. A small a is the length of BC, which is opposite to the vertex A. A small c is opposite to vertex C, which is length of AB. Okay, so before doing the questions of this exercise, I would like to do one question in which, please see, the value of this I consider here B here C and here A. So if I consider here A, then this one will be denoted by small a, this one by small b, and this one by small c. So if I say that B is 60 degree and C is 15 unit, find the value of other sides and other angles. So I told you that when this angle is 60 degree, this will be 90 minus 60. These two angles are complement to each other. So if somebody say that solve the triangle, so to solve the triangle means to get the values of the sides and angles. So in this figure, We have two angles known, angle C 90 and angle B 60. So let us first have angle A. So angle A will be 90 minus angle B 30. Angle B already we have 60. Okay, and angle C already we have. So which other things we want to calculate? This C is 15. This B is 60 degree. Now we are going to use the trigonometry to calculate the length of B and A. We are going to use the trigonometry. Trigonometry helps us to get the connection between the sides and angles. This angle is 60 degree, this side is 15 unit. If you want to calculate this side, you have to use a ratio of perpendicular to hypotenuse. Corresponding to this angle B, this side is considered as perpendicular. And this one is already known, hypotenuse. So when I write B upon C, B upon C, so it is equal to sine B, my dear students. And when I write A upon C, so with reference to this angle, this is base, this is perpendicular, so base upon hypotenuse, this becomes cos 60. So sine B, sine 60. The value of B we want to calculate. The value of C, 15. So sine 60 is equal to B upon 15. A upon 15 is equal to cos 60. And in the video, we discussed that the value of sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Do the cross multiplication to get the value. Multiply 15 to this number, you will get 15 root 3 by 2. A upon 15 is equal to 1 by 2. So A is equal to 15 by 2. So we will simplify. B equals to 15 into 1.732 divided by 2. A equals to 15 by 2, 7.5. So the value, when we multiply, we will get 15 to the 30, 3 carry, 15 to the 45, 48, 4 carry, 15 7 the 105, 109, 10 carry, 15 1 the 15, 10, 25 upon 2. So 2 12 the 24, 2 9 the 18, 2 9 the 18. So the value of B is 12.99, the value of A 7.5, the value of C already given 15, the value of A we have calculated here 30. So I hope it is clear to you. To solve a triangle means to get the values of remaining sides and remaining angles. One more question I would like to do. Let us consider another right angle triangle. With vertex C as 90 degree. So in this right angle triangle, if this is vertex B, so this side's length we will show by the symbol small b. The side opposite to this we will show by the symbol small c. The side opposite to this vertex A we will show by the symbol small a. And if I say that A is 45 degree, so to solve this triangle means, if it is said that solve the triangle, what does it mean? It means to get the values of A, B and this vertex B. So let us first calculate angle B. 90 minus 45. 45. Okay? Second part. This A. The value of A is 7. So, we want to get the value of B and C. This is hypotenuse. With reference to this angle A, this is perpendicular. This is hypotenuse. No? And this one, base. So, we want hypotenuse and base. So, this is perpendicular. So, A upon C. Okay? And A upon B, you do. A is the known side. So, we should do either unknown upon known or known upon unknown. I repeat, you are free to use the method unknown upon known or known upon unknown. So what does it mean? It means the side which is known, it is A. The side which is unknown is C. So I have used the method 7 upon C. And there this side is known and this is unknown. So known upon unknown. So 7 upon B. So when you get the ratio of A is to C, remember my dear students, you are getting the ratio of perpendicular to hypotenuse. So P by H becomes sine. So you will get here sine 45. What about this? You are getting the ratio of perpendicular to base, which is equal to tan theta, tan 45. Tan 45 is 1. Sin 45 is 1 by root 2. Do the cross multiplication. C equals to 7 root 2. B into 1 equals to 7. So the value of root 2 is 1.414. Here B is 7. Multiply. 7 4 is 28. 7 4 is 28. So 9.898. So we have got the values C 9.898, B 7, A 7, angle B 45. So I hope I have made it clear how to use the trigonometry to get one side. Which method do we use? Known upon unknown. The side which you are knowing, either you can put it in numerator or in denominator. So known upon unknown is equal to corresponding ratio. If it is P by H, sign you will write. If it is B by H, base you will write. If it is P by B, tan you will write, as I have done here. This is known side. So known upon unknown, perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So I have written here sine. So known upon unknown. Known side is perpendicular. Unknown is base. So perpendicular upon base. Tan theta. So tan 45 I have used. And when you put the values of tan 45 and sine 45, we can get the value. So rest questions of the exercise we will do in the next video. Till then, bye bye.